Friends at Belmont, we are so close to opening up the shul and we're so excited that, please God, in the next few weeks, even a few days, we might be able to get back into the shul. There's been so much work that's been going on over the last few weeks. I don't even know if you can hear me. Let's take the mask off now, just so we can make sure that you can hear me. So much work has gone in the last few weeks, and I have to give a big thank you, because myself, along with Danny Boxer and Barbara Maslia from the executive, have joined with Philip Bunt, who's been heading our working group, along with Stephen Grossman, Ellis Temelies, Judy Levinson, and together, along with Sharon in the office, and with help from John, as you know, our caretaker, we've been working really hard to ensure that every single thing has been thought out so we can get everyone back into shul in a safe way. So I'm going to give you a little rundown of what it's going to look like, because I know you remember what the shul looks like, but everything for the moment is going to be a little bit different. So first two things is, if you want to come to shul, you definitely need to be wearing one of these if the services are going to be indoor. Outdoor services I'll explain in a moment. Definitely need to be wearing a mask for the duration of the service, from the moment you come to the moment you leave the premises, a mask needs to be worn. And gloves. Gloves are essential, especially for weekday services, because if you're going to be touching any of the keypads, you need to be wearing a glove. And if you're going to be touching the Sefer Torah, which I'll explain about a little bit later, you also need to be wearing gloves. So gloves are really essential, and a mask. When you come to the shul, of course, the keypad is normal, wear the gloves. Come, we're going to go and show you what it looks like now outside. Come with me. Okay, so we're out here in the car park, as you can see. This is where, for the next few weeks at least, Mincha and Maariv services are going to take place. They're going to be taking out here. And if I can get the camera to look down, you'll see red dots on the floor. Red dots. We've got 24 red dots spanned at about 2 meters, at least 2 meters space in between them. And there's a spot here roughly where I'm standing. This is where the chazan, the person that we're leading, will be. So there's going to be dots. We're going to be standing out here. The building will be closed. No entry to the building. The toilets will be closed. The building will be unlocked and open. There'll be a door open in case, God forbid, there's an emergency and we have to get inside the building. That's a security thing. But from a services perspective, no toilets, no access to the building. We'll be doing a Mincha Maariv service out here, weather permitting, and then eventually, hopefully, we'll be able to get into the building for inside services. Okay, as you can see, we're by the front door. We need gloves, again, to be working the keypad. The idea is, once we get inside, you will touch no surfaces as much as possible. So let's have a look what it's going to look like inside. Let the camera go first. As you will see, all the tables have been moved. All the tables, nothing is going to be put down here. I'm going to get you to see the signs here on the doors. It's really important we can see the signs on the doors. No touching of handles, doors, ledges, or any of the surfaces in the nicest possible way. Please keep your hands to yourselves. Don't touch anything. If you look, it's going to be only used as an emergency exit. We've got the sink area here. This is going to be closed off. There's going to be only for the men a maximum of 3 people into the toilets. And for the ladies, it's going to be 2 people at a time. We will have, for the Shabbat services, ushers out here to make sure that we do not have people congregating and we don't have too many people. If we go back to the shul, this entrance, where the men usually walk in on a Shabbat morning, this is going to be for the ladies. And the other entrance, if you follow me this way, is going to be for the men. There are 43 seats for the men, and there are 21 seats for the ladies. So as you've come in, we can see it's really well spaced out. There are markings, if I can get the camera to look at the floor, there are markings on the floor. So even if you do happen to knock your chair out of place, you'll be able to put it back when we ask you to help us with this and keep it as neat as tidy. If you look where the bookcases are, there will be no access to any shul given chumashim, sidurim, tefillin, talis, everything. When you come to a weekday or a Shabbat service, you need to bring your own, and that's really important. Down on the surfaces here, you will notice, please do not place anything on any of the surfaces. That actually, all the way around the building, you'll see signs. Don't put anything down. Really, really important. When it comes to the ark and the bimah and everything like that, it's really important to know that only one person will be allowed up here on the bimah at any given time. Only one person.
You will be allowed an aliyah, don't worry. We'll talk you through all of that for when we come into the services, but there will be a one-way system and we'll ensure that everyone is spaced out really well, and of course everyone's kept at a distance. You know? Now there's going to be a one-way system. So once you've come in through the shul, through the front doors and into this room, you will not be allowed back out through those doors. You'll have to go through these doors, and if you can have a look now, you'll see it's a one-way system. Those doors will be open and you will go out through those doors. So say if you need the toilet during the service, you go through, out through those doors and you come back in to the front of the building. Back into the front of the building and then come in as normal. One-way system is essential for this. Now, the other thing that I want you to know, we are doing our best and really doing our best to ensure that the highest level of safety, security, in every way, shape and possible is done, so we can ensure that when we bring people back here, we are as safe as we can be. In between every time the building is used, the entire space will be cleaned. The toilets, the surfaces, that's why we brought these particular chairs back into the shul, because they're much easier to clean. Everything will be clean in between services, which is one of the reasons why we're going to be doing some of the services outside, and we will not be able to get in here for every service until, well, in the week, until a little bit later down the line and we see how everything's working. You've got a feel for what it's going to look like. Remember, masks indoors, essential. In the service itself, we won't be singing communally. It'll be very functionary at the beginning, but let's get back into shul. Let's get our services and the building used again. Let's do it in a safe way. We really appreciate your cooperation. If you've got any questions, be in touch. And I'm very excited to see as many of you as we can get into this building as soon as possible. Wishing you all good health and good happiness. See you very soon.